Welcome to Thursday. So today we have a coconut curry soup with chickpeas and chicken and hearty greens. So what we have prepped here is some onions. So this is about half an onion diced, red onion, green bell peppers, half, chicken sliced, I've got garlic, chickpeas, this is red curry paste, this is some lemon juice, stock. I have canned tomatoes this today, it gives it a little bit better color. One can of coconut milk. I have a little bit of fish sauce, olive oil, and kale. And so that's about it. This is an easy dish again. It doesn't take that much time. Now, there are two versions of this. If you want to make it soupy, you add a little bit more stock. But if you want to make it like a curry and eat it with rice, you reduce the amount of the stock. So that way it'll make it into a curry. Okay, so I have a pot under medium high heat. So I'll put in about a tablespoon of oil again. You don't have to measure it, just eyeball it. That should be about a tablespoon of oil. Swirl it around. And then add the onions and the bell peppers. And we'll saute it for a few minutes. A little bit of salt, like every day. A little bit of pepper. So with this, I will add the garlic, just give it a few minutes to soften, and then again, based on, look at the temperature, adjust the temperature as needed, we will add the garlic that we minced, and then after that, we'll add the chicken, just to saute it a little bit, not too much. I don't want to give it a color. It's just a light saute. And then we'll season it as we go along. If you have seen my other videos, you have seen that I adjust the recipe a little bit based on, how it looks, how it feels, how things are going. So again, make it your own. Recipes are meant to be, made your own as you cook. So that's the idea here. This is not pre-made or I haven't, this is a new recipe that I haven't tried before. And I'll be making it up a little bit as I go along. So at this point, I want to add the garlic. And like always, let it saute for a few minutes, few seconds actually, maybe a minute, to be aromatic. And then what we'll do is we'll move this to the side and let it cook while we also cook the chicken. The chicken, obviously, we will not cook too much. We want it like a light color as well. So I have a big pot. If you have a smaller pot, you can cook it at the same time. Not an issue. So at this point, when I bought the chicken, if you remember, I'd shown you that I had sliced the chicken and kept it in a bag like this. I thawed it yesterday from the freezer, and then I'm going to use it today. And I never reuse a used bag where I use the chicken or fish or any type of protein. At this point, it looks like it needs a little bit of oil. So if you see here, Just a tad bit more oil might help. I'm just going to put a little bit of olive oil again, just to give the chicken a head start. A little bit of salt. One other tip that I want to give you is before you start cooking, you want to wash your hands. Because, you know, sometimes you touch the food, you might have used it somewhere, not just for now, but always wash your hands with soap and water and then start cooking. So the onions are coming along pretty well. The chicken is just getting a little color, not too much. You don't need to cook the chicken fully. Just a wee bit of color. At this point, you can mix the onions and the garlic and the green bell peppers with the chicken. If you don't want to saute the chicken, that's fine too. You can put it on after you put in the tomatoes, the chickpeas. It's totally up to you. I feel that it gives it a little bit more flavor if I just cook it for a few minutes before I start adding the other ingredients. So it's your choice. You know, nothing, like I said, this is your recipe. Make it your own. So at this point, what I'm going to do is I have a can of tomatoes and I'm going to add that. But before that, I want to add the chickpeas. So this is already from the tin, so it's cooked. So I'm going to add the chickpeas here. And then I want to add the tomatoes. And then the red curry paste. Again, the red curry paste, this one is not that hard, but again, it's your choice. You know, you don't want to use the whole thing. You want to use a little bit less, a little bit more. It's your choice, however way you want it. You know, I want to saute this a little bit with the onions and, you know, this is cold, so I want to just that bit increase the heat and then just saute it for just a couple of minutes before adding the fish sauce and the chicken broth. We'll add the coconut a little bit later. So again, if this is a little cold, so it's, you know, you want to add. So as you can see here, this is like a curry, right? So now it's the time where you want to decide whether you wanted this as a soup, whether you want it as a curry, how much liquid you want to add. So because this is a soup episode, I will add more. I might not need the 32 ounce. I will look at it and see how much you know, I want to add. So this looks where I want it to be. So now I'm going to add a little bit of fish sauce. So in the recipe, I think it says about a teaspoon of fish sauce. Again, it's a salty sauce, so you want to see how much you want. Some people don't like fish sauce. It's your choice again. If you don't want to use it, again, don't use it. So at this point, I want to add the chicken stock. And again, this is cold, so keep the heat up. That's about 3/4 of this 32 ounce can. Whatever it is, yeah. Carton. This looks to be okay for now. If I need to add a little bit more later on, maybe I'll add a little bit more. Bring it to a boil and then we'll add the coconut milk. So at this point, this has come to a boil. So we'll turn the heat down to low and let it simmer. And so it needs to cook, but at this point I want to add the coconut milk. So just add it slowly and mix it. So this will become very rich, with the addition of this coconut milk. So you want a rich Thai curry, broth, soup. This gives it that richness, and then the sour today will come from lemon juice. So we have a little bit of lemon juice that we'll add at the end to give it that soury, spicy taste. So again, bring it up to a boil and let it simmer. It doesn't need to simmer for a long time, but you want it to simmer so that the chicken gets cooked, and then we'll add the kale and let that cook. The kale takes a little bit of time. So if this was spinach, like yesterday, if you have seen the video, it's very quick. But with kale, you really need to cook it for a little bit. So this is, after I put the coconut milk in, it came to a boil and now it's simmering. So at this point, I want to add the kale. So I have about 2 bunches of kale that I bought. I stemmed it, so I took out the stem. It's very hard to eat. This is just the leaves. So at this point, I want to put the kale in and let it simmer again for a few minutes. So that will cook the kale and let it wilt a little bit. So I'll just mix this. So this is looking very hearty, and I'm sure it'll be very tasty as well. The color is beautiful with the tomatoes and the chickpeas and the kale. Smells of coconut milk here. I think it needs a little bit more stock, just a wee bit more. I think this is going to be that's going to be extra today for tomorrow's lunch. So that's a good thing. So like I said, if you want to cook some rice with this at this point, go ahead and cook it and let it simmer, and then we'll taste it, and then we'll finish it off with the lemon juice. So that's the last thing that we will need to put in here. Okay, so this is the finished product. So now let's serve it. So I have a bowl here. Just want to mix it up a little bit, and then let's serve. So like everybody, every day, this is a soup that we can eat. It is hearty, so you don't need really anything else. If you want to add rice, like I said, feel free to do that. You can always add rice to this. You can add cauliflower rice if you like cauliflower rice. It's your choice, right? So, whatever you want. Remember, this is a little spicy, so depending on your spice level, you want to put in the red curry paste. So that's important, right? So you can put in a little bit, taste it. If you want a little bit more, you can put more. I put the whole tin because we like a little bit spicy food, so So you know, it's good for us. But again, this is a recipe that you know, you need to make it your own. So that's it, folks. So for today, that's your Thai curry soup. You know, enjoy, bon appetit, and see you tomorrow with another edition of the journey of a home cook. Thank you again. Have a nice day.